After snubbing committee summons three times, the minister, Mary Grete Kitutu, faced the probe committee and was put on spot to explain how Karamoja iron sheets found their way to Manafa districts and especially in the hands of the minister's relatives, including her mother. But the minister pleaded ignorance and declined to divulge as expected.
There were iron sheets claimed to be sold by your relatives. From the time we started our investigation, it has remained an allegation without any statement made to claim that some of your relatives were selling some of these iron seeds. So we need to get it from you.
Like I said, I don't know. Or those who are selling, that one I don't know.
As the committee chairperson, Jessica Ababiku insisted on the list of other top government officials who received a share of the iron sheets. The minister referred the committee to the OPM storekeeper for details which annoyed legislators.
It was you directing on how iron sheets were supposed to be donated, the one for last year. It was you who instructed for the donations of this year.
You need to own them. You need to tell us why did you prefer to donate an item that was clearly earmarked for particular people, the Karesunas of Karamoja, but you donated to the wrong people.
The Presidential Affairs Committee of Parliament, which is probing mismanagement of Karamoja relief, was later forced to hand over the embattled Minister Kitutu to police after declining to be put on oath by the committee.
If you are not ready to do it, please, we shall not continue with you, but CID, we request that she makes statement on behalf of this committee on the following. One, on the iron seats taken to Manafa.
She was escorted out of the committee by police CIDs attached to Parliament to the Parliamentary Police Post to record statements, and she left Parliament in custody of police.
Where is the lady CID?
The committee also grilled the government chief whip, Dennis Oboa, on receiving 300 iron sheets. However, Oboa denied ever requesting for the iron sheets from the OPM and explained how he distributed the troubled iron sheets.
I wish to categorically state that I have never participated in any alleged mismanagement of relief items, into bracket iron sheets, meant for Karamoja sub-region, and neither did I solicit nor request for.
Now that you've known these items belong to Karamoja sub-region, obviously you got them not knowing, but now that you've known, so what are your plans? Is there anything you want to share with us in regard to that?
The best that can be used is to have me as a witness, to pin their locator, to pin the misleader who did their location. As their locatee, I think there are three fundamental questions I should respond to. Did you receive? How did you receive? Upon receipt, how did you use them? Which I have accounted for.
The State Minister of Karamoja Affairs, Agnes Nandutu, has also appeared before the same committee and submitted that she has already returned the 2,000 iron sheets to police.
Following the advice of police, I was advised to hand over the iron sheets, and that is what I have done. I no longer possess the iron sheets with me.
The committee is now left with the Prime Minister, Robin Nabanja, and the Permanent Secretary of the Office of the Prime Minister, Keith Muhakanizi, to wrap up the investigation. On Monday, police spokesperson Fred Enanga revealed that they had completed their investigations and were now writing a report that would be submitted to the Directorate of Public Prosecution for advice on what charges to prefer. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.